गुड मॉर्निंग गाइस, ओके टुडेस टॉपिक इज इक्वेशन ऑफ कंटिन्यूटी। दिस इज वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट कॉन्सेप्ट इन एंटायर इलेक्ट्रोमैग्नेटिक वेव्स एंड ट्रांसमिशन लाइंस। ओके, व्हाट इज द इक्वेशन ऑफ कंटिन्यूटी, व्हाट इज द पर्पस ऑफ इक्वेशन ऑफ कंटिन्यूटी, हाउ दैट इलेक्ट्रोमैग्नेटिक वेव्स ओके ट्रैवल थ्रू स्पेस, okay how that continuity occurs, okay just like our okay continuity equation in alternative wave circuits, here the electromagnetic waves and transmission lines also have one equation called continuity. Okay, especially this continuity equation states that current density J diverging from small volume is equal to time of equal to the simply rate of decrease of charge per unit volume at any given point, and is simply the potential migrates from higher to lower, okay, like that. See here, that is same is represented as divergence from a small volume. So del dot J, current density J is divergent, del dot, okay, del dot J equal to minus dou rho v by dou t. Okay, where the minus sign indicates okay the rate of decrease, okay the rate of decrease. See here, okay this is the small volume, here it contains a charge q, okay okay simply the moving of charge from this higher level to lower level. What it means, of course that moving is okay in the entire volume rho v, right, okay with respect to time t, okay whenever the charge moved from okay this cubic volume to okay some other point, okay then what is the net charge available here? Is it the net charge increasing or decreasing here? Here the charge is decreased, right? That's why this is minus d with respect to time, okay, d by dt, okay, minus d by dt means with respect to time decreasing of charge density of this particular volume is the rho v, okay, that is the representation, okay. So that is del dot j equal to okay minus of d rho v by dou t. This is the equation called continuity. Okay, mathematically it is also proved, it is very 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 important, okay, in the final examination also it is very important, and competitive exam point of view also it is very important, okay. Okay, that is the equation of continuity statement. What is the statement here? Okay, from the mathematical expression, okay, the divergence of current density equal to decrease of rate of charge per unit volume, okay, or simply the rate of decrease of charge per unit volume, okay, with respect to time. Okay, actually the rate of meaning itself is the time. Okay, rate of decrease of charge, okay, del dot j equal to minus dou rho v by dou t. This equation is the point form of continuity equation. Okay, let's see okay mathematical derivation or simply proof. See here, consider an arbitrary volume, okay. Consider an arbitrary volume V is bounded by a closed surface, just like okay before I draw here one pictorial, right, okay the same is generated here. Consider an arbitrary volume V bounded by a closed surface here, yes, and current density J is flowing through the surface area S. Let a different surface ds with a normal to the direction of current density J as shown in figure. See here, here they consider like this, one cube is considered. Okay, and it's having a charge density or charges Q. Okay, this is the surface area, S. Okay, in that when we consider one unit, okay, that's why it is a differential surface area DS. Okay, current density J, okay, which is perpendicular to that surface area. So let the differential surface DS be normal to the direction of current density J, then the total current crossing the surface area, yes, according to the convection current density expression from the last class, I equal to surface integral of J dot DS, right? Okay, or simply remember I equal to dQ by dt, right? I equal to dQ by dt is the current, right? Okay, current density, how we define that current density J? Current I by S. Okay, from that relation, here I equal to closed surface integral of J dot ds. Okay, the principle of conservation of energy says that charge can be neither created nor destroyed, right? Here one cubic charge, okay, migrated from higher concentration to lower concentration. That's why the rate of decrease with respect rate of decrease of that volume charge. Okay. That's why the principle of conservation of energy says that charge can neither be created nor destroyed, right? That is, outward rate of flow of positive charge is equal to the rate of decrease of charge inside the closed surface. And simply, this concept is just like, when we consider a bucket water here, okay? This bucket having a full of water, okay? Full of water. We simply throw this water outside. Okay, each and every second the water level on that bucket decreases, right? Okay, the similar concept is like this. But here we consider the charge Q. Okay, and this is the cube. The similar concept is this. Okay, but here the water is reduced. Then what about that plucked water from that bucket? Okay. Maybe that the water bought from this bucket is poured into that maybe another small bucket or another small well or anything. Okay, but shape of that environment is quite different, but the water is same, right? That is, the energy is neither created nor destroyed here. Okay, the meaning that is outward flow. See, this is the outward flow of your positive charge is equal to the rate of decrease of the charge inside that closed surface. Okay. So let Q be the charge within the closed surface. Let us assume. Let Q be the charge within the closed surface. Then the rate of charge decreasing through the surface is I equal to minus dQ by dt, right? So with respect to time. Okay, it means the rate of charge of decreasing through the surface and from that surface, okay, how that moving charge, okay, how that charge is moving, okay, can I call it as moving charge is the current? I equal to dQ by dt. Okay, here the charge, outward charge, here outward charge means, okay, the charge is away from that cubic volume. Okay, that's why that is a minus, outward, that's why that is a minus. That is, if it is the inward, that is a plus. Okay. So minus dQ by dt. Okay. Let Q be the charge within the closed surface. Then the rate of charge decreasing through the surface is I equal to minus dQ by dt. So I equal to minus dQ by dt. That is the expression for current, right? So current flow the closed surface. The pictorial representation is like this. So I equal to surface integral of J dot ds is already, you know. Okay, the another definition of that current is minus dq by dt. Okay, what it means, I equal to closed surface integral of J dot ds and I equal to minus dq by dt, both are same. Okay, both are resembles the same expression. Okay, from this simply we equate these two expressions. Okay, these two means surface integral of j dot ds equal to minus dq by dt. So from the divergence theorem, we know that this is the integral form, right? Okay. So surface integral of j dot ds. Okay, by using divergence theorem, apply divergence on both sides. Okay, what is the purpose of the divergence theorem? What is the purpose of the divergence theorem? Okay, divergence theorem simply converts the surface integral into volume integral. That is the difference. Okay, the purpose of the divergence theorem is to convert surface to volume conversion. Okay, so closed surface of j dot ds equal to volume integral of del dot j dv. Del dot j dv. Also, q equal to volume integral of rho v dv. That is also, you know, right? Okay, this expression. Okay, what is going to be rho v? Rho v equal to dq by dv. Okay, from this, dq equal to rho v dv. Integrate on both sides, we get q equal to volume integral of rho v dv. This is the expression here. Q equal to volume integral of rho v into dv. Okay, so now we equate the above two equations. Okay, I equal to volume integral of del dot j, divergence theorem, according to the divergence theorem. I equal to volume integral of del dot j dv equal to minus d by dt of volume integral of rho v dv. Okay. Right? Q is replaced with volume integral of rho v dv. Okay, Q is replaced with volume integral of rho v dv minus d by dt into volume integral of rho v dv. Minus d by dt into volume integral of rho v dv. Okay, so volume integral of del dot j dv. Okay, volume integral of del dot j dv, the same expression equal to volume integral of, can I replace d by dt as a point form as rho v dot? Okay, means d by dt. Okay, sorry, dx by dt. Can I represent dx by dt as a x dot? Okay, for suppose this is the dt square by d square by dt square is the x double dot. This is called point form notation. This is called point form notation. And according to this notation, can I replace minus d by dt of rho v? Okay, minus d by dt of rho v. Of course, minus do rho v by dou t, both are same, right? Okay, why? Because this is a one individual term, that's why that d by dt is replaced as a minus dou by dou t. Okay, minus dou rho v by dou t is replaced with rho v dot. Okay, so this is the volume integral, this is also volume integral. Okay, this is del dot j dv and this is the rho v dot. Okay, and this dv and this dv, both are equal. Okay, and according to the theorem or rule, okay, here integrals are equal. Okay, if the integrals are equal, integrands are also equal. According to this theorem, okay, del dot j equal to minus dou rho v by dou t, that minus dou rho v by dou t is replaced with rho v dot. Okay, so from this, del dot j equal to minus rho v dot, minus rho v dot, del dot j equal to minus rho v dot. Okay, is it clear? Del dot j equal to minus rho v dot. This is not rho v dot, that is minus rho v dot. Okay, this is called equation of continuity. Okay, this is called equation of continuity. Just a second. Okay, sorry for the interruption, guys. Okay, according to that rule, when the integrals are equal, integrands are also equal. From this rule, del dot j equal to minus dou rho v by dou t. Okay, this minus dou rho v by dou t is replaced as a rho v dot. Okay, actually this expression is del dot j equal to minus rho v dot is the equation of continuity. Remember this. Okay, why? Because in the competitive exams also, the equation of continuity is the four most important concept. Okay, and remaining is the cases, all possible cases. See here is the first case. For steady state current, the volume charges. See here, for steady current, what is meant by steady current? Steady current means it is the static type, right? Okay, but del, according to the continuity equation, divergence of the current density del dot j equal to minus rho v by minus dou rho v by dou t, right? Okay, what exactly it means? Okay, with it is it varies with respect to time, right? Volume charge density varies with respect to time, but this is the steady current. Steady current means, okay, static current. Okay, that's why it is the static current, but it is the time varying. That's why it is zero. So del dot j equal to minus rho v dot, but it is the time varying component. But for the steady current, that minus dou rho v by dou t is zero. Okay. This is the static, and dou rho v by dou t is the dynamic. Okay, that's why for the static currents, that rho v term equal to zero. That's why del dot j equal to zero. Okay, for steady current, the volume charge density is constant with respect to time. Volume charge density is constant with respect to time. That's why it is zero. Okay, thus the steady currents are solenoidal. Steady currents are solenoidal, that is, they are not diverged, they are unable to diverge. Okay. Okay, and simply when we take a balloon and fill it with air, okay, I put a hole onto that balloon. Okay, how that balloon shrinks. Okay, that is the concept of divergence. Okay, is it airless balloon is able to diverge? Is it able to expand? Airless balloon. No, not possible. Okay, the similar concept is this. That the steady currents are solenoidal. That is, they are not diverged. Okay, okay, that not diverged in this sense. Okay. A balloon with a hole. Okay, balloon with a small patch. Okay, unable to diverge. The same concept is this. The total charge entering a volume is equal to charge leaving it. And whenever we forcefully breathe out into the balloon, but that balloon has some hole. Okay, is that balloon is able to diverge? Impossible, right? Why? Because how much air enter into the balloon is equal to that much of air leaving from that balloon because of that small patch on that balloon. That's why that is able to diverge. Okay, get it? So that is the statement. second statement. The integral form of the continuity equation, the integral form of the continuity equation states that the current flow outward from a closed surface is equal to the rate of decrease of charge inside that surface. Okay, and just like a this again the same balloon. Okay, air away from that balloon means the rate of decrease of air in that balloon, right? So I equal to surface, closed surface integral of and a closed balloon, okay, with air density as j dot ds equal to minus dq by dt. Okay, and air decreasing in the balloon is simply the moving away, right, with respect to time. Okay, the same concept is this. Okay, all of you get it? Okay, did you get the clarity on the equation of continuity? What is the expression for the equation of continuity? Del dot j equal to minus rho v dot, del dot j equal to minus rho v dot, or simply del dot j equal to minus dou rho v by dou t. Okay, that is the concept of called equation of continuity. And the next equation, next concept is relaxation time. Relaxation time. This is very, very important in competitive exams. Okay. See here, relaxation time is the TR notation. Relaxation time. Relaxation time is the epsilon by sigma. Okay, observe here that epsilon and sigma both are medium constants. Okay, what are the medium constants? Okay, I am the source and you are the destination. In between you and me, okay, what is the medium existing here? Only free space. But that free space having some permittivity, right? Some permeability mu. Okay, permittivity epsilon, permeability mu, and some conductivity sigma. Okay. See here, the relaxation time TR is the ratio of epsilon by sigma. Epsilon is the medium constant. Epsilon equal to epsilon naught into epsilon r. Epsilon naught value is 8.854 into 10⁻¹². Epsilon r equal to 1 for free space. Okay, for remaining materials varied. Okay, sigma conductivity of the medium. So relaxation time TR equal to epsilon by sigma. That epsilon and sigma both are medium constants. Okay, that is the one definition. And simply the relaxation time is defined as the ratio of permittivity to conductivity. Okay, another definition, the charge density through the closed surface, the charge density through the closed surface within a conductor decreases exponentially with time. Okay, the charge density through the closed surface, and just like the above concept, the charge density through the closed surface within a conductor decreases exponentially with the time, means the charge density is rho, which decreases exponentially with the time. And what exactly it means? The charge density rho through the closed surface, through the closed surface within the conductor decreases exponentially. Actually, exponential decreasing means e power minus t, right? E power minus t with respect to time. That's why e power minus rho by t. E power minus rho by t from that. Okay. See here, charge density through the closed surface within a conductor decreases. Decreases means minus. Exponential means exponential with respect to time. Okay. Actually, that is with respect to time. Okay, the same is represented as e power minus rho by t. E power minus rho by t. Thank you. the charge density for the closed surface within the conductor decreases exponentially with time. This is the another definition. Okay. Relaxation time TR equal to epsilon by sigma is the another relation. Okay, the relaxation time TR is simply defined as time taken by the charge density to decay up to 36.8% of its initial value at a given point. Okay, and this is the another definition here for the relaxation time. Okay, here relaxation time has three different definitions. Okay, first definition is e power minus rho by t is the one expression, and second expression is here charge density through the closed surface of the conductor decreases up to 36.8% of its initial value is the second definition, and third definition, a ratio of medium constants epsilon and sigma ratio is the relaxation time. Okay, epsilon is the permittivity of the medium and sigma is the conductivity of the medium. Okay, the relaxation time depends only on medium properties. See here, this is the important point. Okay, the relaxation time always depends upon medium properties. Get it? Here for the relaxation time, have three alternate definitions. Okay, charge density through the closed surfaces in the conductor decreases exponentially with time is the one definition. The relaxation time TR is defined as the time taken by the charge density up to 36.8% from its initial value, and the rise time equal to epsilon by sigma, or the ratio of medium constants, where epsilon is the permittivity of the medium, sigma is the conductivity of the medium. The relaxation time always depends upon the medium properties. Okay, these are the three possible definitions of the relaxation time. This is a very frequently asked short answer question. Okay, remember, just learn what I'm saying here. Just learn. Okay, proof. Okay, it's very simple. Okay, consider a linear and homogeneous medium. Linear and homogeneous medium. Already you know what is meant by linearity and what is meant by homogeneous. Okay, and epsilon and sigma both are constant throughout the medium, then it is said to be homogeneous, right? Okay, consider a linear and homogeneous medium through the constant sigma and epsilon through which the current flowing through the flowing with current density J. Already you know the relation is J equal to sigma E. Okay, J equal to sigma E and sigma into D by epsilon. Okay, how do you get this relation again? Okay, flux density D equal to epsilon E, right? From this relation, capital E equal to D by epsilon. Okay, D by epsilon. So that this E is replaced with D by epsilon. We know that J equal to sigma into D by epsilon. Next, from the continuity equation, we know that del dot J equal to minus rho V dot. Del dot J equal to minus rho V dot. Okay, simply del dot J is replaced with sigma into D by epsilon. So sigma into D by epsilon into D equal to minus rho V dot. Okay, sigma into D by epsilon equal to minus rho V dot. So sigma by epsilon equal to del dot D equal to minus rho V dot. Okay, from the Gauss law, we know that what is the point form of Gauss law? Del dot D equal to rho V, right? So sigma by epsilon into del dot D is replaced with rho V. So sigma by epsilon into del dot D is replaced with rho V equal to minus rho V dot. Okay, sigma by epsilon equal to sigma by epsilon into rho V equal to rho V dot means minus dou rho V by dou T, right? Okay, this is the minus dou rho V by dou T. Okay, and dou rho V by dou T plus sigma by epsilon into rho V equal to zero. Okay, and actually just I move this expression. Okay, I have to move this expression into equal to left side. Okay, then dou rho v by dou t plus sigma by epsilon into rho v equal to zero. This is the first order differential equation whose solution is rho v equal to some constant a into e power minus alpha t by sigma t by epsilon. Okay, let at the initial value t equal to zero. Okay, rho v equal to rho v naught, right? Okay, let at the initial value at t equal to zero. T equal to zero, rho v equal to rho v naught, so that a equal to rho v naught. So from that, rho v equal to rho v naught into e power minus sigma t by epsilon. Okay, by simply solving that first order differential equation, we directly get this relation. Okay. Okay, time constant epsilon by sigma equal to TR is the relaxation time in seconds. Here epsilon by sigma, here epsilon by sigma equal to TR, then okay, that is the basic definition, right? From that, rho v equal to rho v naught into e power minus t by TR, right? Here minus sigma by epsilon is there, but sigma by epsilon is the TR, that's why this becomes 1 by R, so 1 by TR. So rho v equal to rho v naught into e power minus t by TR. Okay, at t equal to TR and both are equal, okay, the relaxation time and the actual input time both are equal, then rho v equal to rho v naught by epsilon equal to 0.368 into rho v naught. That's why the definition here is mentioned as charge density is decayed up to 36.8%. Okay, 36.8%. Okay, so far the same question is asked in only short answer questions, right? And only you have to define that relaxation time. See here, 36.8% or 1 by epsilon, right? 1 by epsilon value is 0.368, okay, times its initial value. So this is shown in figure. See here, with respect to time, the rho v value is up to 0.368 of rho v naught, okay, and reaches up to 0.368 times of its initial value, then it is said to be in relaxation time. Is it clear? Okay, that is the concept of relaxation time. Now the concept called resistance and power, of course this is not much important. but let's see once. Resistance and power already okay. Resistance R equal to V by I, but power P equal to I square R, or V into I, okay, or V square by R. Okay, these are the possible relations in network analysis. But the same resistance and power when we consider an instead of DC, here we consider high frequency AC signals, right? Electromagnetic waves means high frequency AC. In that case, instead of we consider voltage and current, simply voltage V in terms of electric field E, current I in terms of magnetic field H. Okay, the notations are quite different. See here, if a conductor has a non-uniform cross-sectional area, okay, if a conductor has non-uniform cross-sectional area, and the cross-sectional area of the conductor must be uniform throughout its length, then and only it is valid. Okay, for suppose if the conductor has non-uniform cross-sectional area, is not valid. However, from the basic definition, the resistance R is given by, according to the Ohm's law, what is the relation? R equal to V by I, right? But V equal to integral E dot dl. Okay, V equal to E dot dl by I equal to J dot ds. These two relations already okay. That is the resistance. Power dissipated through the conductor due to that resistance, or expressed as from the Joule's law, P equal to volume integral of E dot J. E dot J. Okay, E is the electric flux. Electric field E. J is the current density J. Okay, that's why P equal to volume integral of E dot J dV watts. Okay, here. They meant for volume. Okay, P equal to volume integral of E dot J. E is the voltage and J is the current. Okay, E is the voltage and J is the current in electromagnetic fields. That's why P equal to volume integral of E dot J dV watts. Okay, actually that is the expression for resistance and this is the expression for power. Okay, power density P equal to power density P equal to E into J. Okay, J equal to again sigma E, right? That's why sigma into E, E into E, E square into sigma. Okay, power density P is E square into sigma is the another definition. Okay, for a conductor having a uniform cross section, okay, for a conductor which is having a uniform cross section, then P equal to volume integral V dot J into uniform cross section means length into surface area, DL into DS equal to length E dot DL into surface area J dot DS. Okay, so integral E dot DL and surface integral of J dot DS, okay, is simply this is the potential V and the J dot DS, integral of J dot DS is the current I. So V into I, right? So P equal to V into I, or V equal to IR relation, I into I square. I into I is the I square into R. Okay, simply we put I equal to, or V equal to IR. Okay, so P equal to I square R. For suppose if we put I equal to V by R, then P equal to V square by R. That is another relation. These are all possible relations. Okay, these are all possible relations of the resistance and power. See here, leakage resistance of a capacitor. Okay, this is also much important. Leakage resistance, okay, leakage capacitance. Okay, leakage resistance of a capacitor. But actually, what is the capacitor? Capacitor is the some electric energy storage device, right? Okay, capacitor is especially developed for energy storage. Okay, capacitor is generally useful for storage of the energy. Okay, but instead, okay, the capacitor also dissipates some energy because of the minute resistance available in that capacitor. That is called a leakage resistance. Okay, and how do we represent the capacitor? Capacitor notation, not symbol. Okay, R plus some JXC, right? R plus some JXC. Basically, that is having some capacitive reactance JXC, but in practical, it is also having some R component, R plus JXC. But that R value is always very small, right? 0.1 ohm, 0.2 ohm, 0.3 ohm. Okay, in that order only it is available. Okay, and that much of very low resistance is available. Similarly, for the inductance. Okay, in the order of 1 ohm, 2 ohms, 3 ohms, that range, because of it is the warning. Okay, but when we consider the resistance, okay, 1 kilo ohm, 2 kilo ohm, 3 kilo ohm, okay, relatively that 1 kilo ohm, 2 kilo ohm, 3 kilo ohm is okay, very much large compared to that leakage resistance in inductor and capacitor. In capacitor, it is very low. Okay, one of the reason that capacitor is preferred, okay, for that low leakage, okay, low loss applications. See here, leakage resistance of a capacitor. When the dielectric medium in a capacitor is lossy, where the dielectric medium exists in that capacitor? Capacitor having a two metal plates, right? Metal plate one, metal plate two. In between the metal plates, okay, some insulating material is there. Okay, or suppose that insulating material is the paper. Okay, that capacitor is called a paper capacitor. If we use some electrolyte, that is the electrolytic capacitor. Okay, if I'm using carbon, that is the carbon capacitor. Okay, some insulating material. Okay, if I'm using ceramic or plastic, okay, according to the dielectric material that name imposed, the dielectric medium is the capacitor. Is lossy, a small amount of conduction current will flow between the plates. Okay, the expression for resistance, and actually no, it must offers very high resistance. The dielectric medium between the two metal plates of the capacitor must offers a very, 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 very high resistance, or simply insulator purely. That's why no current conduction takes place. if it is a pure dielectric. But very small amount of conduction current will flow between the plates, okay, because of that leakage resistance. The expression for the resistance and the capacitance for a given lossy dielectric medium is R equal to V by A is already, you know, Ohm's law. Okay. Similarly, capacitance C equal to Q by V. Okay. The product of R and C, V by A into Q by V equal to VV. Both are cancelled. Q by A. RC equal to Q by A. The medium be the homogeneous, the electric field E is established in it. Okay. See here, RC equal to that Q as D dot DS and I equal to J dot DS. D is replaced with epsilon E. J is replaced with sigma E. Okay, sigma E cancel. Okay, epsilon is a constant. So epsilon, when we check outside, integral of E dot DS by E dot DS, both are cancelled, epsilon by sigma. So RC equal to epsilon by sigma seconds. Okay, which represents the relaxation time of that medium, right? Epsilon by sigma. The leakage resistance of a capacitor is obtained from that above equation. Okay, the leakage resistance, okay, of the capacitor can be obtained from the above equation. Consider the capacitor filled with a dielectric medium having a permittivity epsilon and some conductivity sigma. The resistance of the capacitor is the leakage resistance between the plates. Okay, why? Because these two are the constant for a given medium. The leakage resistance of the parallel plate capacitor R equal to epsilon by C sigma. Okay. What is meant by sigma here? Epsilon. Okay. C equal to again epsilon by D. C equal to. Okay. And when we substitute here. C. When we substitute the C here, R equal to epsilon D by epsilon S sigma. Okay, that epsilon cancel D by S sigma. Okay, R equal to D by S sigma ohms. Okay, that much of resistance, that much of leakage resistance occurred. Okay, within the capacitor. Okay, where D is the separation between the conductors and S is the surface area of the plates. Okay, for a single isolated sphere, the leakage resistance. Okay, for a single isolated sphere. For a single isolated sphere, the leakage resistance R equal to epsilon by C sigma from the above expression, or simply epsilon by C equal to 1 by, right, for a sphere, for a single isolated sphere, for a sphere that whose value is capacitance value C. Okay, next you have to derive the same. C equal to 4 pi epsilon A. Okay, where A is the diameter of the sphere. 4 pi epsilon A. Okay, when epsilon both are cancelled, R equal to 1 by 4 pi sigma into A. Okay, where A is the radius of the sphere. For coaxial cable, okay, next you have to derive the two expressions. Capacitance of that sphere and the capacitance of the coaxial cable and capacitance of the two parallel lines. For coaxial cable, the leakage resistance R equal to epsilon by C sigma equal to, for coaxial cable, that capacitance value C equal to 2 phi epsilon L by natural logarithm of B by A, inner radius and outer radius, B by A means. So natural logarithm of B by A by 2 phi sigma into L, epsilon cancel. Okay, and that is free from or independent of that permittivity. Okay, where B is the outer conductor radius and A is the inner conductor radius, and L is the length of the cable. Okay, these are the possible relations or leakage resistances of the capacitor, all possible resistance and power, relaxation time, and equation of continuity. Are you clear? Okay, but in today's concept, we'll learn these topics: equation of continuity, relaxation time, leakage resistance, and power. Okay, leakage resistance. Okay, I think time is not enough for that boundary conditions. Okay, this is a somewhat lengthy topic. Okay, it may take one complete class. Okay, that's why I finish with this topic. Tomorrow I will continue this remaining topic. Okay, from boundary conditions and Poisson's and Laplace equations. Okay, thank you everybody. Okay, for careful listening of this class. Thank you everybody.